And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
Hello and welcome to SL Chennai Speaks Out. There are so many sports in India: archery, badminton, billiards, boxing, wrestling, kabaddi, to name just a few. Then why does only cricket get the attention that it does? To analyze sports, we have with us Venkatraman Ramnarayan, who played cricket for the country in the 70s, and he now writes on the sport. We have Shihan Husseini, the country's highest ranking black belt holder, who has an 8th dan in Ishin Ryu Karate and is also the secretary of Tamil Nadu State Archery Association. He teaches both karate and archery. And our other guest is Anand Filler, a freelance sports journalist, who interestingly writes about every sport other than cricket. India's golden girl P.T. Usha burst into tears recently when she felt insulted by the sports authorities at Bhopal. The former sprint queen came to Bhopal with three students from her academy to participate in a national athletics meet. When no arrangements were made for her and for her team, she ran from pillar to post, and then when she couldn't handle it anymore, she finally burst into tears at a press meet. Let's start by watching this story.
A sight that moved almost an entire country. P.T. Usha in tears after seeing the accommodation she was expected to stay in Bhopal.
Sai ka governing body ka member hai main. India ko kitne medal, 102 medal mila tha pehle main India ke liye. But itna main expect nahi kiya tha. But pata nahi wo log aisa tha mere ko kya hai ki hamara India ka sports aisi hai. Isliye to hum log ekdam piche hai world meet mein.
But thankfully the smile is back on her face.
I don't know, some hotel called Jahanuma.
Yeah,
there they should take, but for me, I had come to see the race, not to stay at the hotel and all. But the problem is when I came, I was waiting and roaming. That was a problem actually. But they had come and they were not at all, because they have realized, I think.
Realized they certainly did. After the national press had splashed the news on every channel and newspaper, everyone from the sports minister of the state down to the organizers rushed in to placate the Payoli Express, though nobody was willing to take the blame.
Sai hamare under mein hai nahi. Yahan par Madhya Pradesh Athletics Association apne aap mein ek NGO hai.
Sports Party of India ko iske bare mein khabar nahi thi. Local organizers ne usko receive kiya airport pe PT Usha ko, aur unhone socha shayad usko wo apne athleton ko sath rehna chahegi Sai mein. वो उसको ले गए जो उसे पसंद नहीं आई, लेकिन लोकल जो ऑर्गेनाइजर्स थे उनके पास इन्फॉर्मेशन था कि उसने अपना होटल खुद बुक किया हुआ है.
श्योर मिस्टर भनोट, दिस मे हैव बीन अ सिंपल केस ऑफ मिसकम्युनिकेशन, बट व्हाट अबाउट अर्लियर इंस्टेंसेस ऑफ एपथी व्हेन पीटी उषा वाजंट इवन इनवाइटेड टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ द एथेंस ओलंपिक टॉर्च रिले इन दिल्ली इन 2004.
जो भी हुआ है बहुत बुरा हुआ है. मैं समझता हूँ कि आने वाली जनरेशन जो है वो क्या सीखेगी इन चीजों से. जो हमारे हीरो हैं उनकी हम ये इज्जत करते हैं.
The anger is justified. Sadly, it's not just funds, but a little more respect that can make other sports richer in this country. With Rubina Khan Shapu in Bhopal and Vikram Chaudhary in Chandigarh, Anusya Mathur for NDTV.
So let me start with you. How do you think the public would react if the person in question there was an important Indian cricketer?
You'll get a flash news. You'll get a breaking news in every media, and everybody will talk about only thing. And rest all life will stop.
But the point I've been making here is, would we be jumping up and down if that was an Indian cricketer, sir?
Definitely yes, because right from Sharad Pawar to Lalit Modi, everybody would be hogging the limelight. There is no, the sports authority haven't come out. There is some minister in Madhya Pradesh or Bhopal where who comes out and apologizes.
Somebody will be sad.
And then people will forget it. Today do we remember that this happened to P.T. Usha? If it was Sachin Tendulkar or leave alone Rohit Sharma, we would still be talking today that day Rohit Sharma was left unattended, or Sachin Tendulkar, the god of Indian cricket, was left unattended. But why cricket? Why singling out cricket?
Right. So let me ask Ram, why is cricket as popular as it is today?
Cricket is, I think it's an Indian game.
Is it in fact?
Yeah.
That's news to us.
It's
from the British
Guard. If you, it's athletics Indian?
or hockey, is it Indian? Football, is it Indian? Cricket is Indian because that is where we first started beating the Englishmen. So there was a lot of pride. Cricket doesn't need the fitness of a sprinter or a marathon runner. It needs brain. It needs people who can outmaneuver, outthink people. And it's perfect for Indians.
Right. Mr. Mahindran, you're a cricketer. You're a former cricketer. Now, is all of this due to the 1983 World Cup, the way the television saw it live, great excitement? Is that where it all started?
No, not really, because cricket, if you look back in the 60s and 70s when Pataudi, and it's still a popular game. Cricket was always been popular because it had some kind of charisma in it. The game played for a whole day. There's so much of time to talk about the game. There's so much of time to learn about the game. Hey, I think cricket has been called, it has got the saying that cricket is an institution by itself. It's not only a game.
Right. Let me turn to you, Anand. How has cricket become so commercial?
As far as cricket is concerned, there are a couple of aspects. Which is the first game that you pick up as a child? It is cricket. So it is ingrained in us, whether you like it or not. We can have, you know, thousands of panelists and thousands of discussions. It's not going to change. The fact is, it is in our psyche as Indians. That is one aspect of it. And number two, when I first started out as a journalist in Bangalore, I used to travel by bus for Ranji Trophy matches along with the cricket team. I mean, I have sat with Brijesh Patel, G.R. Vishwanath, B. Vijay Krishna, Sadanand Vishwanath. You all travel together in a team. I mean, can you imagine that today? The media and the cricketers, you're sitting there and playing rummy to pass time. And I shared rooms with some of our Ranji cricketers because there were not enough rooms available. But I think in 1983, after the World Cup, I think things changed. And you had these marketing kids, and India opened up to the world. And you had these marketing guys coming in, and they realized the actual value of the game. I mean, they're just monetizing the sport, which is what other sports too should be doing instead of complaining right. about cricket.
So I don't think that other sports have been getting that kind of attention. One, two, about the psyche of the Indian mind, that boys, I still do not know the rules of the game, and I don't think any child grows up knowing what cricket is all about. Archery is much into your psyche. I think there's not a single person in this audience who would not have had a broomstick and a throw-up and shot archery. I don't think there a single child would have not learned how to grapple with each other, wrestle, punch at each other like karate. Much later in life, we learn cricket. So I strongly feel that it is the media, the cricketers themselves, everybody hyping it up into such a huge game. And I think that the right attention has to be given to every other sport, including archery and karate.
I would like to congratulate media on P.T. Usha's note, because without media, P.T. Usha's thing would have not come to us. Okay, and because of that, the Madhya Pradesh CM has written an apology letter to P.T. Usha.
I am going to need to take another opinion from you, sir. Yeah. We'll give you the mic.
I just agree with whatever sir said, right? I mean, all this comes as a child. I mean, I was a cricket buff, and I'm still a cricket fan, a crazy. I grew up with cricket, okay? I mean, right from the days, those transistor days when commentary was there, breaking connections and all that, we all grew up. It is in our psyche, basically.
Cricket, they say it was in their psyche. I don't believe that. Cricket is a gift given by the British of 250 years of colonialism. That is still running in our blood. Whereas hockey, chess, shooting, you have Abhinav Bindra who's won, but not at the expense of the government or the federation. His father was a rich guy, so he had his own basic facility and he won at it. So we as public also need to be more responsible and support people who are good at it.
Of course, we're all talking here about the media. So did the media make a mistake, Anand, when we had the 83 World Cup live, the way it went?
No, I don't think so. End of the day, it's like this. If I'm starting a TV channel, how am I going to set it up? What are the factors that come into play?
Money.
Yeah. End of the day, the only thing that talks is money. I mean, we might talk endlessly about, cricket being a colonial game and, the media is ignoring this, media is ignoring that sport. But end of the day, we are running a business.
Media house has a responsibility apart from them conducting a business. I started introducing archery into this state, and I know the difficulties. I've been running from pillar to post. I must have sent 1,000 faxes to all media houses to highlight a selection or a state competition. Not a single newspaper has published anything. I'm coming straight from a state selection. We keep saying that archery, there's no other game is being promoted. The media is to squarely be blamed because you do not recognize any other sport but cricket and a couple of games.
Yeah. Right. I'd like to hear from someone who hasn't spoken.
Cricket is today what it is today. It is only because it runs through the entire day. Media people have commercialized space on that. Other games, they are completed within 1 hour or 1.5 hours, where you get hardly 10 minutes for commercialization.
Basically, now most of them believe what they see. Now, the moment a child switches on the TV, he sees a creator pops up and he poses some ad on it. So that's the way a child, from the small age itself, what he sees, he believes in. He keeps on seeing the cricketers, and so he's interested in seeing cricket more, basically. And moreover, if the media people start highlighting some other sport, the attention would go there. So basically, I would like to say that the media people are majorly involved in bringing up cricket in such a big level.
See, cricket is the good saleable product in India.
No other sport is saleable? I would like to ask you, Mr. Manu, what about squash? Tell us about that. Is that not saleable?
I think all sports are saleable.
Then why isn't it getting the money that it should be?
If you want to buy something, you want to buy something that you would be satisfied with. So if I was to invest money today, if I were going into advertising in sports, I would choose cricket because the entire country would watch cricket, and that's where I'm going to get the best returns. I'm saying that squash is sellable, but not as sellable as cricket. Therefore, we lose out to cricket. What we need to do, though, is all other sports should try and emulate what cricket is doing and try to raise the profile of their respective sports, which I think we are doing in squash.
Right. Yeah. Okay, fine. It's time for us to take a very short break, but we'll be right back with you on SL Chennai Speaks Out.
Chennai Speaks Out is brought to you by SL. It's time to move on.